Welcome, Anu. And Anu's story is blessed by a Hindu god. And Anu, if you were food, what would you be and why?
So I'm going to skip away from the sweets. If I was a food, I would be cilantro.
Nice.
Nice.
And why? So the cilantro, very aromatic, very bright and green. It's used in a lot of bases in Indian food. So as an invisible, it provides a lot of flavors. So I do a lot behind the scenes. But sometimes if cilantro is used as a garnish on top, it's bright and green. And so if I'm asked to be on the stage, I can do that sometimes. But also, cilantro, if anyone knows, some people love cilantro and other people hate cilantro. There's some people who know me who really like me, and there's other people who know me. So I'm going to tell you a vegetarian story after the last one. I was raised a Hindu, and if you know Hinduism, this is a religion that's full of feasts, festivals, and fasts. And I'm going to be talking about fasting a little bit. Now, many religions have fasting. Jewish people do Yom Kippur, Christians Lent, Muslims Ramadan. But Hindus really embrace this notion of fasting. We take this seriously. You have 1 day fast, 9 days fast, 30 days fast. You're fasting for the hope of getting something. You know, you wish for something and you fast for it. And you target a particular deity. So on Tuesdays, many Hindus will fast for the god Hanuman, the deity, and he'll bring them good luck. Okay? In my family, we didn't fast too much, but my mother, she observed a fast, as many married women do in India, even in modern India. It's called Karwa Chauth. On one specific day of the year, women will fast from sunrise to moonrise, not a drink of water, nothing to eat. But it was a communal event. All the women relatives and friends would get together. They'll take the day off from work, or most of them if they could. They would exchange gifts, they'd wear new clothes. And what was the highlight of the day was right at sundown, they would run up to the terrace to see who could watch the moon come up in the sky. And at that point, they could break the fast. Mm. And legend has it that the reason they did this was, you know, back in ancient times, they were praying for the safe return of their husbands who might have been gone off for war. Mm. So it didn't work out that way for my dad, but that's a whole different story. So, you know, in India, it's usually women who fast. Men don't fast, children don't fast. But there was this one fast that some neighborhood girls in my area did. It's called Gauri Vrat. And it was done by unmarried women and young girls. It was a 5 day fast each year. And the reason for this fast was to get a good husband. And the idea of this fast was you didn't eat any salt for 5 days and you didn't eat grain. You could have fruit, you could have dairy, so lots of milk. You could have sweet, just no salt. So you did this for 5 years, every year for 5 years, right? And I was about 7 or 8 when I started this fast. And the legend for this one was Goddess Parvati, she did fast. She fasted so that she could get God Shiva as her husband. And she fasted this, and she did this for a number of years, and then she got him. And another story has it that there was this childless couple who prayed to Lord Shiva to bless them with a child. And he was very happy with their penance. And he said, can you go into the forest and take care of this temple there? And so they did. And they, you know, worked very hard, and they took care of this temple. And one day, the husband went off into the forest to pick some flowers for the temple. He got bitten by a snake and he fell down unconscious and he didn't get back home. The wife was very distraught and she prayed and prayed and prayed to Lord Shiva. And finally he was so pleased with her prayers that he brought her husband back to life and he went back home and they had a baby and that was the start of this fast, right? So here I am, 7 or 8 years old, maybe 9, and you know, the neighborhood girls are doing this fast and it's for a good husband, and I'm thinking, okay. You know, what appealed to me was you got all these new clothes, you got this jewelry, you got a lot of attention, right? So yeah, you know, every night you had to, they take dollars one up, you know, henna on our hands, we'd go to the temple and you'd have to bow in front of Goddess Parvati and pray ostensibly for a good husband. And all I could do, what my brothers, older brothers had taught me to do, is to say the alphabet backwards. Well, so I did this fast for 5 years, right? And you can do it for 5 years and then you could do it for a second set of 5 years. It's an advanced course. So I was 12 or 13 and not married by that time, right? So I said, why not? Let's do it for another 5 years. So I do another 5 years, right? By then I'm 17 or whatever. No husband. And Goddess Parvati says, you know, you get two times. You get two chances, not giving you a third chance. Well, the thing is that I didn't get a husband. You know, not even, forget a good one. I didn't even get a husband. I was fine with it. My parents though, you know, Indian parents, fairly modern, but what they were thinking about this fast was, you know, Indian parents are judged by the ability to marry off their daughters, right? So if I got a good husband, then they're successful parents. They've done their job. And on the flip side, if I don't have a husband, then they have not done their job right. Oh. Right? They failed as parents. And not that they expected that this fast would get me a husband, but it was like an insurance policy. You know, dip it a little bit and maybe she'll get a husband. So the, you know, my 20s and 30s were spent kind of my parents trying to get me a husband and me trying not to get a husband, right? So they keep sending me these messages and, you know, it was just a kind of a guilty feeling because I was letting them down. I was letting them down as parents. Forget my satisfaction, my happiness, you know, the fact that I was a successful professional, I had a job, I had a good life, I was happy. I didn't have a family, you know, and I didn't have a husband. And that, therefore, I was not going to have kids, and they were not going to have grandkids, you know. So it was a very difficult time, but I failed. But then, you know, it was much later that I started to think, you know, maybe that fast was a good thing. Maybe it actually worked for me. My friends were getting divorced. By my mid-30s, early 40s, on their second divorces. So yeah, maybe this was quite all right. My parents were getting used to it too. You know, they were trying to come to terms with it. Early on, it was, I had to marry a Hindu man from a certain area of India. You know, we are from Northern India, and so he had to be from Northern India. Well, that didn't happen, so they expanded. When I moved to the States, they said, okay, any Indian. And then that didn't happen, and then they were like, any man. Please, can you just get married? So it didn't happen, and you know, finally, I think now my mom is like, yeah, I think you did okay. You did just fine. But you know, I think about it, and I wonder if I might want to take fasting up again. You know, not not to get a good husband. That's way beyond that now. Not really for, you know, health reasons, the cleansing, get the toxins out of the body. I don't quite believe in that either. But I think that, what fasting does, it helps you control your body, it helps you control your mind. You know, it gives you a little bit of resilience. And I wonder that the fasting that I did, and you know, I'm not a sweet person, I'm a salt person, I'm a savory person, I like chips. So for me, while the fast was not difficult, we had plenty to eat. After the second day, I started to crave salt. But what it taught me, you know, by the third and fourth day, when I was really just wanting that bit of salt, was a resilience, right? And I wonder if it gave me the courage to let my parents know that I wanted the freedom to be single. And now, I wonder if it might be good to do a fast, you know, for different reasons, you know, to remind myself in some ways that you need to have that control, to not get complacent. That there are people out there who fast not because they can, but because they cannot afford to eat, right? And maybe that might just be a reminder to ourselves. And also then, I think it might help me savor my food a little bit more, especially during holiday time in the company of friends and family, even if the seat for my husband is empty at the dinner table.
Thank you.